Yeah, I've been kidnapped. 30 minutes later, your kidnapper dumps you on the street because you won't stop talking about what? Constantly making eye contact and asking what is wrong. My theory on how Kim Jong-un is actually both gay and Remy from Ratatouille. So let me tell you how Linux is a far better operating system, and how the modern internet owes its life to free and open source software. Henry VIII, second verse, same as the first. Warhammer 40k. The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy by Douglas Adams. I would recite my Vaughan poetry. Lego O. This One Piece only came in one set issued in 1984. It was a limited edition set, so there weren't that many to start with. But a lot of pieces from that era are now lost or in landfills. So it only comes up for sale from time to time, usually at auction. One sold in 2003 for $72. Can you believe that? 72 for a single Lego piece. Anyway, every time I buy used Legos, I always check for that piece. So there's other pieces like that too. It isn't just the one piece. There was another piece. Well, actually a minifigure. That was all gold. Not like that fake plastic looking gold, but actually shiny. Wait, where are you going, guys? Hey, I'm almost done. You gotta hear the rest, guys. You see, everyone just uses the shield wrong. You don't always need it out. You can deflect skeleton arrows and even creeper blasts. It's totally worth a 16th of the screen you lose while you have it equipped. And infinity. What a joke. Get a Fletcher or a skeleton spawner and you're set for life. Why not just add mending into the mix? And don't even get me started on how much more people should be using potions. You know, instant harming second can direct. Every single mistake they made in the planning and execution of said kidnapping. My cat's gambling addiction. My cat. My D&D campaign. The entire story and character construct of the Kingdom Hearts series. The fact that College Board basically has a monopoly on the college credit entrance business, at least in the US. But we use them in an international school I went to too. And how competition is necessary for apps sats. Act CCT. To be cheaper and more reasonable. They are bad for the higher education system and everyone in it. Some chick wouldn't stop pestering me at the bar one time. So I made up a whole fake backstory about being a washed up Disney Channel star, until she eventually got bored and left me alone. I made up a theme song and everything, and basically wouldn't let her change the subject. I'd probably just do that again. Big edit. Let me tell you about the Y2K Disney shit show that was Bud Chasers. Don't look it up. So exactly how much do you know about the show Bud Chasers? Nothing. Boy do I envy you right now. The premise was basically four best friends discover that the evil Dr. Merkin is planning to release his Y2K bug into cyberspace. Aka the Cyberzone. Picture a great value boy band style of archetypes. A bad boy. A jock. The prankster me. And the brainy one. The brainy one. Takashi. Builds a portal to the Cyberzone. So we could battle the computer bugs in a very poor CGI world. Basically reboot VR Troopers Code Lyoko. We each had a specialty and a color scheme. Where I was cast as the green bug chaser, Louis Snot Bukowski, who was equipped with a slime cannon and other gross bug traps, stink bombs etc. There were a ton of ongoing gags, particularly between myself, Takashi, and our big sister Melissa. If you've been keeping up with the name so far, you may have noticed that Takashi, who was the yellow bug chaser, has a significantly more Asian sounding name than Louis or Melissa Bukowski. This is never explained. This is never even addressed. Even with 13 episodes shot and 26 planned, it wasn't even touched upon. Anyways, our big sister would usually tease him for being a dork, or get mad at me for being gross, and she'd always get her cumuppance for being an outright BTCH. She'd get zapped ducking with electronics, have sync bombs go off on her, and even got sucked through the portal into the infamously disgusting cyber slug zone. You know how each Walking Dead episode had that one scene that was just gratuitously disgusting for no other reason than to try and one up the previous episode? That became a thing with Melissa, but it took a far more skeevy route. Firstly, let's cut to the chase, get it? You're probably more wondering What happened to this show and my career? The show was straight up cursed. It was supposed to go along with an arcade shooter and Sega Dreamcast game. With basically no other merchandising. The death of arcades and the Dreamcast flopping nixed that. The Blue Bud Chaser. Johnny the Jock wielding a long-ranged bug zapper was paralyzed, while his mother was driving drunk and wheelchair-bound right before the fourth episode was shot. They told him they were just gonna roll with it, but ended up replacing him. I won't forget the heartbreak on his face when he showed up to the set, only to find out he had lost more than his mother and use of his legs. But the chance to defeat Dr. Merkin and be the hero kids need. The animation department was never given the funding they needed to begin with, but also suffered a computer virus that required them to turn in their machines to the police. The resulting CGI was about 5 years behind its time and couldn't grab kids' attention. The characters were barely likable to boot. Takashi was a nerd, and his main job was to do technical stuff for the group, and he didn't even get a cool weapon. Not that the weapons were terribly cool, with Disney trying their best to avoid anything too gun-like. The Red Bud Chaser had a ducking flissvitter. Johnny had been replaced after 3 episodes, meaning they reshot a couple scenes where they could, redubbed lines, and ultimately cut a lot of material featuring that character. I was the most well-liked character by far, being the zany little scuzzball that I was. My mom was ducking the producer, so I think my character got a little bit more to work with that. And how my character played off of Melissa. You know how Nickelodeon producer Dan Schneider has a little girl foot fetish? Our producer, Mitch Michaels, had a sticky little girl leftish. It was only mildly noticeable on screen. Maybe her shirt was just slick enough with green slime to make out her bra line. Maybe it was the way she spit take the slug mucus. But it was way worse on set. Mitch put way too much time into reshooting these scenes, which often required multiple wardrobe changes just offset too, not in a dressing room. I won't bore you with those details, because there was also quite a bit of arsism on set. Aside from the very on-the-nose casting of an Asian kid as the Yellow Bud Chaser, Johnny had it worse as an African-American. Takashi was typecast as a nerd. But Johnny was supposed to be the bad boy, with a very negative thug-like personality. They didn't change it because of complaints though, no. They changed it when Mitch was informed that, much like the Red Power Ranger, the Red Bud Chaser was sure to be the most popular. That's when the one black kid was essentially demoted from red to blue. When Johnny 1 was replaced by Johnny 2, and they were said to do reshoots and edits. Something was said to the effect of Thiel never even notice if it's a different black kid. Fear all the same. All he saw was a black face filling a role. He even started making us call each other by our character names off camera. Until there was no Johnny 1 and Johnny 2. But just Johnny. I don't even remember the original Johnny's real name. But I do remember the money shots. So Melissa was being pushed into increasingly sticky situations, with way more takes of spare footage than any slapstick gag deserved. Mitch insisted that they were the main selling point of the show, and even started using the term money shot each episode. On the episode after the mid-season finale, we were supposed to fight an invisible spider bug in the dark web. The solution was for me to spray glow in the dark slime on it so the others could see it. The prop gun was a unique custom build that was way more important than the modified super soakers I was used to. The premise was that we had janky kids next door style gear that was digimorphed into cool equipment when we went through the portal. I wasn't allowed to goof around on set with this custom prop because it had to function just so. Melissa walked on the set and was given the half-assed setup of blowing dust off of her diary. There was a subplot there about stealing it, losing it in the cyber zone, then having to go back and fight some dust bunnies for it, or whatever. It gets blown in my face. I sneeze and accidentally set off the glow goo gun. This squirted a thick, creamy rope of pale colored goo directly on her face. She tastes it. Is this frosting? End scene. There was a hushed murmur around the room as Mitch stood there almost wheezing. He had the type of face that a starving man gives a hibachi chef as he waits for a shrimp to get tossed his way. There wasn't a second take. The scene died on the cutting room floor without ever being matched with a laugh track. It died as stark and naked as Melissa's innocence. We were all hurried out of the studio by flustered parents, whose reaction made us feel a sort of nervous shame. The scene shot heard around our world. The show was cancelled shortly thereafter, having only half a season air. Mitch was fired, and there was a huge class action lawsuit based around a pedophilia case. The computers that were taken by the authorities had child porn on them, many of which were pictures of child actors. My mom got too full of herself and wouldn't take the settlement, insisting on a lead role for me instead. But her mouth couldn't influence them nearly the way it influenced Mitch. My role was half voicey over work, and my character usually wore goggles even in the real world, so my face was mostly forgettable. This would be the end of my show business career until my work on an adult film set years later, but that's a different story. The kidnapper not giving me the candy for getting in the van. My newest MLM adventure. The Python programming language. I'd like to talk to you about your car's extended warranty. How whale DCKS are probably the origin of sea serpent legends. Endlessly critiquing their kidnapping plan as I suggest better options. You know, the zip tie's an ice pick, but theoretically easy to snap with since effort. Personally, I'd suggest rope or even paracord. I hope you remembered to wear a disguise when you rented this van. They have CCTVs everywhere nowadays. Neither of us need your face on TV. So what's your endgame here? Is it money? Arrest time thing? Revenge? Arrest time thing? I just like to know what's on the itinerary. If it's one of those other things, can it also be arrest time thing? I mean, it's not my fault you didn't think to sedate me when you picked me up. Frankly, that's a rookie mistake. Raid, Shadow Legends. That my dad can beat up his dad. Reciting the B-movie script. True crime podcasts edit. No joke. A friend of mine owns a bar, and whenever I'm there, we have a deal. If people stay too long after last call when she's trying to close up, if I can get them to leave, I drink for free. My go-to is to start telling stories about my favorite true crime cases, and it works almost every time.